Now, Junior 5, let's start our new unit, Unit 3, Lesson 1. Unit 3, speaking about environmental balance. We said that we need to keep the balance of the environment to make sure that all living organisms can live with each other, okay? Which means that we need the plant and the plant need us. So both of us depend on each other. Okay, Junior 5?
Okay. Okay.
Now we have living organisms. Okay. We have two types of living organisms. Number one, producer. Number two, consumer. Number one, producer. Number two, consumer. Producer from the verb of produce. So, living organisms, they generate the food. They generate the food for themselves. Have you listened to me? Junior 5, لو سمحتوا اللي فاتح المايك وفي جنبه دوشه يا ريت تقفله.
بس دي فلوس مجمعه.
ايه اللي مش هتفهم وهي تتكلم بس؟
Junior 4, Junior 5, all of you mute the speakers, would you please? Okay, we said that we have two types of living organisms, producer and consumer. Producer, from the name, they will produce or generate. We studied before what is meant by generate. So, producer means they will generate the food by themselves. So they don't depend on the others. They don't depend on the others. Okay, Junior 4. But in case of consumer, consumer means they don't produce anything. They don't produce anything. So they will depend on the others to can eat the food or to can produce the food. Okay? So producer means they generate the food for themselves or for the others. But consumer means they don't produce anything. They will eat the producer or consumer or both of them. Clear, Junior 5?
Okay.
Okay. Now we will start with the producer living organisms. Producer living organisms like what? Like the green plants. Like the green
plant.
Okay. Green plants make a process, I think you studied before, which is talking photosynthesis process. Photosynthesis process. This process, they will need three things from the surrounding. They need what? Three things from the surrounding. They will need, number one, sunlight from the sun. Number two, carbon dioxide from the surrounding, water from the soil. So all the green plants need three components from the surrounding. Number one, sunlight from the sun. Number two, carbon dioxide from the surrounding. And number three, the water from the soil. Junior 5, all of you would please mute.
عندي question. فهو يعني الديوني والدروزيرا دولت يعني اللي هم يعني اللي هم من اللي هم يعني consumers عشان بياخدوا ال insects ولا autotrophic زي plants العادية.
No, they will depend on the other to get their food. So we can't consider all of them as a producer. They will be consumers. Start speaking. What's your name? Are you Hazel?
Miss, can you repeat? And I said that. مش سالي can you repeat؟ أنا لسه داخل.
Okay, Adham, we didn't say anything. We said that we have two types of the living organisms, producer and consumer. Junior, for food, please. اللي بيلعب بالمعرفش بالبند ده ولا ايه؟ Stop.
ازاي بيلعبها؟
All of you muted, Junior 5, all would you please? Number one, we said that now we have, or we start with the first producer that we have, which is called green plants. We said that green plants need tree from the surrounding. They will need the sunlight from the sun. They will need carbon dioxide from the surrounding. And they will need the water from the soil. The water from the soil. Okay? After that, they will produce, their nutrients and oxygen. So we can say that green plants are called autotrophic organisms. Why we said that autotrophic? Auto means self. Autotrophic means that they can produce or they can prepare their own food by themselves. They can prepare or they can produce their own food by themselves without depending on the other junior five, without depending on the others. Clear?
Okay.
Now we will start with the relationship of the food. We will start with the relationship of the food. All living organisms, due to the presence of the consumer living organisms, so they will depend on each other. We said that consumers, so they will depend on the producer or on the other consumer to get their food. So now we have relationship between all living organisms because they will depend on each other. They will depend on each other. Okay? We have three types of the relationship. Number one, predation. Number two, symbiosis. And number three, saprophytes. Okay, so we have predation, symbiosis, and saprophytes. Now we will start with the first one. I need all of you start with the, when I need the definition of each one of them. So all of you have to start with this statement is consistent with us, okay? Which is, it's a food relationship among living organisms, okay? This will be consistent with us for each definition, for each relationship. Virginia 5, so we will start with this statement for each definition in this lesson. It's a food relationship among living organisms. In case of predation, it will consist of two types of animals. It will consist of something called predator and prey. Predator and prey. So predation predation is consist of two types or two main points or two main organisms. One, predator. Number two, prey. And one will devour the other. One will devour the other. So if we have cat and dog, so in this case, cat will be the prey and dog will be the predator. So we can differentiate between both of them. Predator means the living organism which devours the other living organism. One prey that devours the animal. As we said, if we have cat and dog, so cat will be prey because it will be the devoured animal. But dog will be the living organism which devours the other living organism. Clear? Can you remember, Jennifer, a temporary magnet? We said that temporary magnet for few moments, right? We said that temporary magnet due to the presence of the electromagnet.
Yes.
Once the current is cutting, so no magnet that we will have, right? The same also here. In case of the predation, it will be temporary relationship. Why? Because in case of the presence of predator and the prey, so we will have predation. Once one of them started to devour the other, so the predation is ended. So we can say that it's a temporary relationship. It's a temporary what? Relationship, because it will be for a few moments, or it will need specific conditions to be available. Once this condition is ended, so this predation or this relationship will also end. Now we will start with the examples of the predation in the animal and the predation in the plant. Okay, predation in the animals like a lion preys a deer, a wolf preys a rabbit, a cat preys a rat, spiders where they make woven to catch insects. So now, junior five, we can say that lion, wolf, cat, spiders are prey or predators?
Predator,
super. But deer, rabbit, cat, insects are
prey.
Super junior five. Because the lion, wolf, cat, spiders, they will devour. They will devour the others. But deer, rabbit, rat, insects, they will the devour. Okay. All of you meet junior five. Junior five, all of you, make sure that all of you are mute. Okay, the second predation will be in plants, will be in the plant, okay? We said that plants are phototrophic or producer. So we said that plants can make their own food by themselves without depending on the others. Why now we need prey and the predator in case of plants? Because that some types of plants can't make their own food. Some types of plants, junior five, can't make their own food. So we will find that some types of plants will depend on the others, so they will be consumer, not producer. Once we started to depend on the others to make our food, so it will be consumer, not producer, because producer means to produce their own food, to produce their own food, okay? So predation in the plant, it will be less common than in animal for sure, because all animals are consumer and all animals are depending on the others in their food, in preparing their food. But plants, most of plants can make their own food by themselves. Most of plants can make their own food by themselves. Okay, but some of plants can't make their own food by themselves. So they will depend on the other to make their food. So we have the reason predation is less common in plant world than animal world. For sure, because plants can make their own food by themselves due to the presence of photosynthesis process. What are the examples, Junior 5? All of you, would you please, that all of you are mute, Junior 5. All of you mute, Junior 5, if you want. Now we have two examples about the plants that they will be. Abrahman, keep mute. Now we have two examples about the plants that they can't make their own food by themselves, like Drosera and Dionaea. Okay, Drosera and Dionaea. Both of them are examples for insect eaters. Insect, what junior four? Five, I'm sorry, eaters. What is meant by insect eaters? So they will depend on the other insects in preparing their food. So they will be consumer because they can't make their own food by themselves. Drosera? Drosera has sticky material, okay? This sticky material will sticky the insects that will stand on it. So they started to be, to start to absorb the proteins from these insects, okay? But in case of Drosera, Dionaea, it will open its mouth like that you see here in this case. Once the insect started to be sub on it, so it will close it for the insect and started to absorb the proteins to take their food. Okay, Junior Five. Now.
طب مش المفروض دايونا احنا لو جينا برضك نحط الصبار اللي هي برضك بتقفل علينا مش الاكس انت انسكت بس
هي بتبقى sensitive to anything that will stand on it. Once they feel that anything that will stand on it, so it will start to catch it to take the proteins from it. Whatever about what is the living organism that will stand on it. Okay?
Okay.
So any good reason about Drosera is an insect virus plant. Insect virus means insect eaters. Why Drosera is an insect eaters? Because it will depend on the other insects to get the required elements to make their proteins. Okay? Now we have complete predation. We said that predation is less common in, we said that predation is less common in plant world than in animal world.
Animal.
All animals depend on, all animals can depend on their other animals who can get their food or on other living organisms in general who can get their food. But in case of plant, we said that most of plants are producers, so they can autotrophs, don't forget. Producer, both of them have the same meaning. But most of animal plants can't make their own food by themselves. Okay, what and what? Are so it will be Dionaea and Drosera. The devoured animal is known as devoured animal, so it will be prey.
Miss, this is prey, drop.
What?
Miss.
What?
This is prey, drop.
I don't know the page in the book.
73 of
36.
No, thank you. Thank 37. You, Junior Five. All of you stop.
What is
open your booklet and you can follow us.
Thank you, 36.
Thank you, Junior Five. Now all of you mute. All of you mute.
I will mute.
Thank you. Now we have to wait Junior Five to can make the prey protect themselves from the predator. We said that in case of predation, so the prey will be devoured from the predator. But now we can, or we have two ways to make the prey protect themselves against the predator, okay? We have something called camouflage and something called mimicry. Camouflage, once you listen, camouflage, you have to mention color. What is meant by that? Camouflage, it's a phenomena in which the living organisms protect themselves by hide. How they can hide from their enemies? by changing their colors to be a blend with the surrounding environment, which means that if the environment or if the surrounding environment is colored with brown, so the prey will change its color to brown. If it surrounded with it is surrounded with a green color, so it will change the body to green color and so on. Like here we have butterfly stands on the tree with the with a orange color of the flower. So we will find that its color is semi-like the flower. So the predator can't distinguish very clear the living organisms from the flower. Clear, Junior 5? And you can recognize it very well in case of the frogs like here. Frog takes the same color of the surrounding environment. So if the predator is passing through it, so it can't distinguish it very well. So it can protect themselves by using this way to change the color of the bodies depending on what is the color of the surrounding for it. Okay, like here, Panther Camelot, it will change its color depending on the surrounding environment. But in case of mimicry, mimicry depends on something called imitate. So camouflage depends on change the color. But mimicry depends on. But mimicry depends on imitate. What is meant by imitate? Imitate means to copy or take of. To copy or take of the color or not the color. Imitate means copy or take of the characteristics of the others. For example, now we have B and now we have WASP. Okay?
WASP.
B is a harmless animal, but WASP is a harmful animal. So WASP can fright or can escape from the enemies easily because it's a harmful living organism. But B is harmless. What is meant by harmless? So it can't escape from the enemies easily. So B started to imitate WASP in the sheep. It looked like the WASP. Why? Because or to can escape from the enemies easily. To can once the enemies started to see it, it will consider it is a WASP, not bee. So you can understand what is meant by mimicry. Mimicry, we have two living organisms. One of them will be harmful, but the other will be harmless. And the harmless living organisms started to imitate the harmful living organisms. Clear, Junior 5? Now we
Miss, I don't understand.
You don't understand the mimicry?
Yes.
In case of mimicry, we have two living organisms. We have two living organisms. One of them will be harmful, but the other will be harmless. And the harmless animal or living organism started to imitate. Imitate means copy or take of the shape of the harmful animal. Why? To can escape from the enemies or to can fright their enemies. Because when you see the bee, you can consider it as a WASP. So you will be escape or you will be fright from the bee. Understood?
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
Understood.
Okay, Junior 5. And now we will start with the second relationship. Now we will start with the second relationship, which is which is called symbiosis. What is meant by symbiosis? Symbiosis, we said that it will be the second type of the relationship. and it will be between two different living organisms. It will be between two different living organisms. Adam Tamer, stop playing with you, please. It will be between two different types of the living organisms. We have three types of these relation. We have something called mutualism, commensalism, and parasitism. Okay, we have mutualism, commensalism, and parasitism. We will start with each of them. Mutualism means what? Mutualism, it's a food relationship between two living organisms. We said that this statement will be with each other for each definition in this unit, okay, or in this lesson. Abdullah, stop playing. Junior 5.
Miss, I don't understand.
Miss, what's the meaning of relationship?
Relationship is something like the net or the communication, something like the communication.
Okay.
Like the relationship between the human and the green plants. We depend on the human in the photosynthesis process to produce oxygen gas, to can use it in the breathing or the respiration process. And the other green plants depend on the human to produce carbon dioxide, which they will use in the photosynthesis process. So now we can say that there is an relationship, or there is a relationship between human and plants. Understood, Junior 5?
Yes.
Okay. Mutualism, now we will start with the first one, which is called mutualism. What is meant by mutualism? We start with the statement, which is called, it's a food relationship between two living organisms. It will be the food relationship between two living organisms in which each of them gets benefits from each other. What is meant by that? Let's start with the examples to can understand it. We have something called leguminous plant. What is meant by leguminous plant? Leguminous plant like the peas. Okay, this type of plant is called leguminous plant. These leguminous plants have a specific type of bacteria in the roots called nodular bacteria. Called what? Nodular bacteria. This type of bacteria started to help leguminous plants to collect the nitrogen from the soil and started to fix it in inorganic form. So number one, these nodular bacteria that's found in the roots of the leguminous plant started to collect the nitrogen from the soil. Started to collect the nitrogen from the soil. And the fix means keep it constant. What?
I have a question. The plant gathers nitrogen or carbon dioxide to make oxygen?
No. Carbon dioxide from the air to can make the photosynthesis process to can produce oxygen and the nutrients. This process is called the photosynthesis process. But now we are talking about different process.
Okay.
Okay. It don't depend on the nitrogen or the carbon dioxide from the surrounding. Now, nodular bacteria starts to collect or gather the nitrogen from the soil, not from the air. Okay. Because it's found in the roots of the plant, and the roots for sure become under the soil. Junior 5, would you please stop playing?
I'm not playing. I'm not doing this.
I said for the who doing this. I don't say the names. Clear, Junior 5. So now we start with the leguminous plant, And leguminous plant started to collect or gather the starts to collect or gather the information, the nitrogen from the soil. Started to gather the nitrogen from what? From the soil. Okay. So nodular bacteria started to collect the nitrogen and fix it in the roots for the leguminous plant. So it helped leguminous plant to collect the nitrogen or to fix the nitrogen in an inorganic form. But we said that in this relationship, both of them will get benefits. Now nodular bacteria, until now, it doesn't get the benefits. So the plant started to provide these nodular bacteria with sugar. Why? Because it helped the plant to collect the nitrogen, and the plant help it or give it sugar to make both of them are benefit. Both of them are what? Benefit. So nodular bacteria help the plant, and the plant help what? Nodular bacteria. So both of them will be benefit. Both of them will be benefit. Okay? And the plant produce or provide this sugar due to the photosynthesis process. So it will be the first one, which is mutualism. Okay, Junior 5. Now we will start with the second type in mutualism. But don't forget that now we are talking about these are three types of symbiosis. What? Commensalism, we will start with the, our fixed statement. It's a food relationship between two living organisms. Adam Khaled, stop playing.
Yeah.
So I'm telling
them. It's a food relationship between two living organisms. One of them benefits from the other, while other don't get benefit, but at the same time don't be also harmed. So now we have two living organisms. One of them will be benefit, but the other no benefit, no harm. No benefit, no harm. Like what? Like here, we have a relationship between a tiny aquatic, and tiny means living organisms if they live in the sea. Okay, so now we have relationship between a tiny aquatic living organisms and sponge. So now we have two living organisms. This tiny aquatic living organisms will start to use the sponge as to get the food and shelter. And shelter means to get to take it as a help or a hope, to escape in it, to live or to live in it. Okay, so these tiny aquatic living organisms will get food and shelter from this canal and fissure of or inside the sponge. So now we have two living organisms, tiny aquatic animal and the sponge. Tiny aquatic animals get the benefits, food and shelter, but the sponge get benefits? No. Get harmed? Also no. So this is mean commensalism. Clear, Junior 5? So mutualism, both of them get benefits. Commensalism, one of them will get benefit, but the other, no benefit, no harm. Clear, Junior 5? In case of parasitism.
So I can't understand them. I can't understand the commensalism.
Commensalism, we have two living organisms. One of them will get the benefits, like here, tiny aquatic get benefits. Take food and shelter, or get food and shelter. So they get benefit. Benefit means to take the positive side or take the uses of the thing. Or to be, or to have the useful side of the thing, like here. It takes the positive side or the useful side. It can get food and shelter. So both of them considered as a benefit for it. Understand?
Yes.
But in this case, a sponge get benefit. He didn't take anything from the tiny aquatic animal, right?
Yes.
Get warmed? No. Tiny aquatic animals didn't make anything harmed for this sponge. They just live inside it. Understood, Junior 5?
Yes.
Super. Number 3, in the symbiosis, parasitism. What is meant by parasitism? We will start with our fixed statement. It's a food relationship between two living organisms. It's a food relationship between two living organisms. One benefits from the other and known as parasite, while the other is harmed and known as host. So now we studied three types of the relationship for the symbiosis. We have mutualism, both of them get benefit. Okay? Commensalism, one of them get benefit, but the other, no benefit, no harm. Number 3, parasitism, one of them get benefit, but the other will be harmed. The one who get the benefit is called parasite, but the other who get the harmed side is called host. Okay? And this relationship can be from the external possession or internal possession. What is meant by external possession and internal possession? External possession means the parasite, which means that it will be the benefit side. The parasite lives externally, which means that outside. Adam Tamer, stop playing. The second time, Junior 5, I will stop the online session. Junior 5, stop playing, would you please, all of you? Stop playing, Junior 5. External, I said stop playing, Junior 5. Muhammad.
It's not me.
I am not playing. He is playing.
Meet all of you. External parasitism. What is meant by external parasitism? The parasite lives externally on the host's body and feeds by sucking the blood of the host. What?
Missing screen, صارت عندي مش شايف حاجة.
اعملها من على الفيت وفين.
Set it from your setting.
أنا تك عليها تاني. تك عليها. تك عليها.
تمام خلاص.
External parasitism. The parasite lives externally, which means that outside on the host's body and feeds by sucking the blood of the host. So now we have two living organisms. One of them will be parasite, but the other will be the host. The parasite started to sucking the blood of the host. Sucking means taking, okay? Or feed on the blood of the host, okay? And so it's not rich to kill you, but it will make you weak or make you have disease. Okay? Something like the mosquito. Super. Mosquito started to sucking the blood from your body. Why? Because it can feed by this way. So sometimes we have a lot of types of mosquito, Junior 5, by the way. So sometimes cause something called malaria disease, and you have to save the name of the parasite and the name of the disease that they will cause for the host. So mosquito cause malaria. And we have something called lice. They live in the hair and they started to sucking the blood from the head. We have something called phlegm, which is cause blood disease. And this is the blood disease. Okay. We have something called bug.
Bug.
We have something called tax. Jawless, and jawless is a type of the fish. Started to sucking the blood of the fish. Okay.
This is kill you. It kill you.
It's not reaching to kill you because it's something not positive for the parasite when you are dying. Because it needs you to can sucking the blood from you. If you die, so it can't find the food. So it will just disease or make diseases for you, not kill. So it will make you more weak. Okay? It's not something positive for it to make you die. If you die, so the food of it also dies. Now we have the second type of the parasitism, internal. We said that external depends on the outside, right? So for sure, internal, it will depend on the inside or it will live inside. So the parasite started to live inside the host's body and they share the host in its digestive food. All of you need to reply.
Yes.
Internal parasite means that parasite will live internally, which means inside the host's body and started to share the host in its digested food or sometimes feeds on its cell and tissues. I think we studied before that all living organisms have systems and this system is consists of organs and these organs consist of and cells consist of tissues. So cells and tissues are the components of the organs. So sometimes this parasite started to feed on maybe the digested food here with the host in its digested food or started to feed on its cells and tissues. Like what? Like Bilharzia worm. Most of them, by the way, they will be worms. I think you know that the worms live inside the body, like Bilharzia worm, and it will cause Bilharzia's disease. Scarce worm and cause anemia disease. Tab worms, filaria worms, and called something called elephantiasis disease. Elephantiasis disease, like that you see right now. It comes from the elephant, so their legs become look like the elephant's legs. Okay, liver worm. Now we will start with
Miss, what is the liver?
Liver worm is a type of worm that they, it will live inside the body to share the host in their digested food or depend on feeding on the cells and tissues.
Miss, you mean that it will harm the liver in our body?
It will harm the liver because but it's don't for you, Yani. We have filaria worms, scarce worms, and Bilharzia worms only. If I didn't mention the disease junior 5, it means that it's not for you. You have just to say the name or to the name of the worm. Clear junior 5? If I don't mention the disease of the worm, so this means that you don't need to know it or it's not on your curriculum. Clear, junior 5? Now we will start with the with the third one, which is called saprophytism, which is called saprophytism. Saprophytism, you have to start with our fixed statement. It's a food relationship between the living organisms. But here in the saprophytism, we will find that we have two living organisms. One of them will call saprophytized, and the other will call decomposer. Okay, saprophytized or decomposer, and the other will be the decomposing living organism. So it's a food relationship in which saprophytize or decomposer get their food by decomposing the food remains or bodies of dead living organisms. I think all of you know that once the living organisms died, we started to put it inside the soil or burying it, and after a period of time, it will be decomposed. It will be what?
Decompose.
How they can be decomposed by using the specific decomposer organism. What? I didn't hear.
Mini school. مش في واحد يعني كده مثل جاهزين جنب بعض.
هذه. Saprophytism, we said that once the living organism started to, or after the living organisms died, we started to put them inside the soil or burying them. After a period of time, we will find that these living organisms. We will find that these living organisms started to be decomposed. Did the five all of you mute? It will be decomposed. Decomposed by what? By the presence of decomposer living organisms. Some types of living organisms started to decompose or feed on that this decomposing process, like this mushroom, like the mushroom, like the bread mold fungi. This green color means that the decomposing process. Okay, why this decomposing process happens? Because there is some types of decomposer, some types of decomposers, animals or living organisms, I'm sorry, will feed on these layers, okay? Like the bread, like the decomposers of orange fruit, because it will produce something called penicillium.
Can you make the people who are chatting stop, because this confused me?
Stop chatting, Dennis. Why?
سالي.
What?
أنا مش فاهم مي ال بيأكل بي بي بيأكلوا زي بيجيبوا البروتينز زي.
Proteins? In the green plants? You are talking about Drosera and Dionaea? عبد الرحمن. What?
يلو الفانكس دخلت الجسم بتاعت الهيومن هتضره صح؟
Who? You said what? Repeat it again, I'm sorry.
يلو الفانكس.
Yes.
الحاجات دي الانسان بالغلط بلاها هتضر صح؟
You mean
disease.
The warmest? You mean the warmest? For sure, Junior 5, all of them, once they enter your internal
side. سمح حضرتك.
once all the
Miss الصوت بتاعها بيلاج قوي.
Miss I can't hear you.
Miss I can't hear or see you.
Now you can hear for me, Jennifer. Can hear me, Jennifer, all of you?
Miss, I can't hear you.
I can see or hear you.
Okay, you can see me because I closed my the camera.
Yeah.
You can't hear me?
Yes.
Thank you, Jennifer.
Yes.
Stop.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Okay, Jennifer. By the way, our time is finished. By the way, our time is finished.
Yes.
And
yes.
Finished
yes. 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 Yes.
Thank you, Jennifer.
Yes.